want to get my hopes up.
I know, but it's something to hold on to. Your eyes reacted to the light.
Yeah, but I didn't really see anything.
Well, who cares? Maybe that'll happen next time.
I don't know.
Oh, come on, Noah. Even Dr. Oliver said that this was a great thing, and he rarely says anything positive, so it's huge. Hey, this is exactly what you wanted. I'm so happy for you.
What? Order a CT for him. I'm on my way.
Why don't I take you out to dinner tonight? To celebrate. Yo, nothing like that. At all. We can invite some friends. Casey, Allie, some of your film crew buddies.
I would, but, well, I can't do dinner tonight.
Why not?
I have plans.
You have plans? Noah, do you have a date?
I'm having dinner with a guy I met.
Well, that's pretty much considered a date.
Luke, it's just dinner.
You know, we could go back and forth like this all afternoon.
Please, don't make something out of nothing here.
What's his name?
Richard.
Where'd you meet him?
Are we really gonna do this?
Yeah.
I met him at therapy.
So he's blind too?
No, he's not blind too. He got into a car accident a while back and hurt his hand, so he's been going to the same place I do for PT.
And he asked you out on a date.
Luke, how many times do I have to tell you it's not a date?
So he's not gay? Is he gay or not, Noah?
Yeah, he's gay.
Well, then that sounds like a date.
All right, you know what? Fine, it's a date. Does that make you happy?
Do you like him?
He's funny and nice.
Great.
It is nothing, okay? It's just easy to hang around him right now. There's no pressure, which is exactly what I want and need. Someone who's not, you know...
Me?
I didn't mean to hurt you,
no,
okay?
No, it's fine. I shouldn't have asked. You didn't want to get into it. I shouldn't have pressured you.
Look, it's just easy to spend time with Richard.
Easy.
I don't feel like I owe him anything. You know, we don't have any history. He doesn't hover over me in case I fall, and I don't feel any pressure from him to be the old me because he doesn't know the old me.
So I hover and I pressure you. Got it.
He doesn't love me, so he doesn't try. Fix me.
Let me get this straight. You want to be with somebody that you don't love.
Luke, I am not with Richard. But it is easy to hang around with him right now. Can't you just accept that without getting all worked up? I've explained it to you.
You know I wanted to be there for you.
And you also said that for us to be together, it's the all or nothing. Well, I can't do all right now. Richard and I are friends. That's it. Come on, what are you thinking?
That this sucks.
Well, I'm sorry you feel that way.
When are you meeting him?
Soon.
Then I'm out of here.
Luke.
No. Noah. I want you to get what you need. More than you will ever know. But I'm not gonna sit here and watch it happen.
Well, Dr. Oliver.
You're back. Nice trip.
Yes, thank you. We have to talk.
Well, I've got called in for a head trauma. He's being scanned right now.
Dr. Oliver, the man that's suing you for malpractice has lodged a complaint with the Medical Licensing Board.
Meaning what?
Meaning that they're opening a formal investigation into the death of Annie Judd.
Okay. Thanks for the tip.
No. The guidelines of this hospital state that if you're under investigation by the medical board, that you're put on suspension through the duration of the inquiry.
You're not serious.
I'm sorry.
That's draconian, Dr. Hughes.
Well, be that as it may.
Overrule them.
I can't do that.
Yes, you can. You just won't because you're a coward.
Don't you talk to my husband like
Hi,
that.
Hi, I'm the best surgeon at this hospital. I do something that matters. And what do you do? Oh, that's right. You produce tabloid television.
Okay, that's enough. You can say what you want to me, but you make one more remark like that to my wife, I'll knock you on your back.
Go ahead, Bob. Great example to set. Then we can both be suspended. Let the interns run this zoo into the ground.
All right, come with me and keep your mouth shut.
What the hell are you doing? Let go of me! hell are you doing? I was in the middle of a conversation with my chief of staff.
No, you were about to get canned by your chief of staff because you couldn't stop running your mouth.
Well, I'm already on suspension thanks to Mr. Judd's malpractice suit against me. Now, Dr. Hughes, who fought so hard to keep me here, is turning his back on me.
Can you stop being so outraged and just try to toe the line?
Could you try taking a hike since you don't know what the hell you're talking about?
All right, the first thing is you've got to respect Dr. Hughes a little bit more. No matter what kind of information he's in charge of delivering to you.
You don't get it. He could have fought for me. He's choosing not to. He's sticking his head in the sand. I'm the one who's going to lose my career, not him. They might as well just shoot me. It'd be a hell of a lot easier.
What are you talking about? If I can't work, if I can't be in the operating room, I've got nothing. But you yourself said that these charges were baseless.
Nobody's listening to me.
Well, then get yourself a lawyer and fight for it. Make them listen to you and just keep doing your job.
I can't do that. I am on suspension until the inquiry's closed.
Well, maybe that's a good thing.
Why? So I don't accidentally kill Noah, too?
No. So you can focus on getting these charges dropped.
I can't focus without my work. I haven't had more than a day off since I started med school. It's all I know. All I am is a doctor. Without it, I truly don't have anything else to hold on to. That's why, Mr. Snyder, I need you.
You need me.
For what? Your name, your money, your power, all of it. I want to use it.
How?
Bribe somebody, blackmail them. I don't care. Just get me back in the operating room.
Well, the thing...
Look, I don't know. I know you don't care about me. Why would you? But if you can help me, I can help Noah. Isn't Noah the one man in this world you love enough to do anything for? Why did you come back here?
I need to talk to you. Here's the thing. I'm not going to do anything illegal, immoral, or underhanded, even if it's for the right reason. I've done it before, and it never turns out the way I wanted it to, and I never feel good about myself afterwards. It makes me feel like I'm Damian Grimaldi's son.
You are Damian Grimaldi's son.
Yeah, you called me Mr. Snyder for a reason.
Well, I guess I'm out of luck then. A plea from a lovesick boyfriend to a medical board isn't going to get me back in the operating room.
Probably not, but I think my grandmother might.
Come again?
She has friends in high places. I asked her for help, and because she loves me, she made a few calls.
To whom?
The Texas Medical Review Licensing Board. They scheduled an emergency hearing. So you have to go and you have to fight. Well, but I guess you fighting and saying that you're right probably wouldn't be very hard for you. So this is the part where you say thank you.
Thank you.
Well, don't schedule any surgeries. We have a lot of work to do if we're going to beat this.
We?
Yeah. I'm not letting you do this alone. I'm going to Texas with you.
How many private planes does your family have, anyway?
Do you want to get to the board and plead your case or not?
Yes.
Okay, good. I ordered us some takeout from Al's.
Al's?
You have a problem with Al's?
No, it's just it being your grandmother's plane and all. I thought they'd have white glove in-flight catering. You know, borscht, caviar, whatever it is you people eat.
That's not really my style.
I got chili. With cornbread?
Yeah.
All right, excellent. I'm gonna get some magazines for the flight.
Okay, well, don't be long.
It's a private plane. Don't they wait?
Just go.
Hey, your order's ready, Mr.
You know what? Just in.
Are we going or not?